This is me, the End of the Viking, and I want to talk to you about this game. It is called Vintage Racers. Vintage Racers is a game where each player is going to draft a old-timey race car, and then they're going to take that old-timey race car, and it comprises of three different parts, and so you're going to draft those three different parts, and they're going to have different stats, and that is going to be the stats of your race car. And then what happens is then you are going to take that race car and you are going to race it against everybody else's race car that they just put together. The actual racing is a very, very fast, like, kind of simultaneous movement type of situation where, like, each person will pick the speed that your car is going to be going, and then you are going to be able to, like, move that many spaces on the board depending upon who's going fastest. Then the next person goes, the next person goes, the next person goes. However, there's, like, tricky turns or whatever that are going to do damage to the tires of your car and also use up, like, basically each driver has their driver skill, and then they have these driver tokens. These driver tokens will allow the players to either, like, avoid damage to their car as they're going around turns, or they'll allow them to kind of cheat, and, like, if their car, you know, has a top speed of like 80 miles an hour, they can cheat that one turn and make it go like 90 miles an hour that turn. If their car has an acceleration of 20 miles an hour, they can cheat and make it 30 miles an hour that particular turn. But you have a limited number of those, and so you have to kind of pick and choose where you're going to be using those cards. Let me show you how the game is played, and we'll come back here and I'll give you my final thoughts. All right, so this is Vintage Racers. Just a couple of quick things. One, I don't have the actual cool little race cars. I have these little wooden sticks here that are going to represent the cars. But just so you know, as with any prototype that I was sent, once the game is published, you're obviously going to see a lot of upgraded components and some different art. So just keep that in mind and go ahead and check out the Kickstarter page if you want to check that stuff out. Also, I've set up a track here, and this is a pretty simple track. You're going to get a ton of these cards that are going to allow you to create whatever track you want. One of the cool things when I played this with my son, like, he was always trying to make the most crazy tracks that he possibly could, and we had a lot of fun with that. One of those things that I do enjoy about games is that they're fairly modular, and you can just kind of do whatever you want. It actually reminds me a lot of games I played when I was a kid, and this was kind of like the commonplace thing. But anyway, I'm getting a little bit of a little nostalgic there, but just something that, you know, non-structured, if you will. And you know, being able to, like, kind of uniquely make a game is always kind of fun as well. Also, I'm going to show you how you draft your race car over here, but there are tons of these race car cards as well that have all three of the different parts. So just keep that in mind as well that, you know, you can play with just more than four players. You can play with two. It doesn't really matter. We did play a few games of, like, a ton of, like, you know, 5-6 players, you know, all racing at the same time. Good stuff, lots of fun. Just, once again, the more things that you can do to change up how the game is played and just make the game your own, the more fun you're going to have. All right, so the first thing that's going to happen with any game is you're going to determine the first player. You can do that however you want. The game, the rules themselves say, like, whoever was the last person that was at a motor race is going to be the first player. But, you know, you can roll a die, play rock, paper, scissors, whatever. It doesn't matter. Next thing you're going to do then is the first player is going to draft one piece of their car. You can see there's three different pieces. And this is the back end of the car, this is the middle, and that's the front. I'll talk about what all these icons are and everything that those do here in just a moment. But just keep in mind that the first player will then pick, and you'll go around the table, everybody will pick a part, and then the first player will move to the next player clockwise on the board, so then that person will pick next, and so then it'll go all the way around and so on and so forth. So the first player doesn't get to keep picking first each and every time. Each part of the car will have different stats that will adjust different things that are going on. For example, the tail end or the back end of the car has this icon that has this little number and has a little flag on it. That will determine the starting speed and also your pole position to begin the game. So you can see, like, 50 is going to be the highest. So if you have that, you are going to be at the pole position. You're going to be in the first car to go. As the game progresses, the speed of your car is going to change up and be altered. So keep that in mind, that is going to happen, and that just because you're the pole position car doesn't necessarily give you the leg up, if you will. Now, the second part of the car is this middle part of the car, and it's going to have a lot of different stats on it. And these are a little bit, might be a little bit confusing at first, just because I remember when I first saw this, I thought, oh, well, that's the accelerator pedal. Well, no, that isn't actually accelerator. That's the braking. So this car can brake 20 miles an hour safely. And this car, this number over here with the lever, that is actually like the gear shift, like grinding gears or whatever. That's your acceleration up over here. So your car each turn can accelerate 30 miles an hour. However, this number here is the max speed that your car can go. Now, these numbers that are here, like the max speed or the acceleration or whatever, those can get altered and changed by using up driver tokens. You're going to get 5 driver tokens that you're going to be able to use as the game progresses, and I'll talk more about those as well. Basically, those allow you to break the rules and allow you to do things that normally your car wouldn't be able to do. Now, you'll notice all of the parts of the middle of the car all have those 3 stats on them. What changes things up is the front part of the car. The front part of the car is going to alter one of those 3 stats. So you can see, like, this car right here, this car gets plus 10 braking because of that front end. Whereas this car here, if you had this part, you would get plus 20 to your top speed. So the front ends actually are going to be different. And as always, as I said, you're going to get lots of different cars, you know, like lots of different front ends of cars and whatever that you're going to be able to use. Now, before I step away from that, I want to point out one other thing. You'll notice that on the 2 parts of the car, they have these spots here with the tires. And the tires have either, some of them are blacked out and some of them are open. When you're racing your car, when you go into turns will have certain numbers on them telling you that's the minimum speed that you have to be going, otherwise you're going to damage the tires of your car. And so what happens is that if you decide to go faster than that, you're going to do damage to tires, and you're going to have to place these wooden tokens, these cubes, on the empty spots, the non-blacked in spots of those tires to show that you've taken tire damage. Once all of that tire damage is filled up and you don't have any more, you cannot go faster. You cannot take any more tire damage. I mean, your car doesn't like blow up or anything like that. But what happens is that you are not allowed. You have to figure out a way to travel through those spots, either abiding by the speed limit of those turns or using up driver tokens if you have those left, and to basically escape being able to, you know, break the rules once again. So just keep that in mind that, yeah, you're like, oh, why wouldn't I take this? Why would I want to take the car that starts off at 20 miles an hour? Well, you'll see it has all 4 of its tire spots open, meaning that you're going to be able to, you know, just burn a lot of rubber, so to speak, and like literally, so to speak, to keep your car going fast around the track. But anyway, so once everybody, and you can't draft multiple parts of the cars. You have to each draw one. So if I got to go first and I was like, you know what, I want to start going 50 miles an hour, I want to be in the pole position, I would take that. And then like the next, so if the next 2-3 people all took, let's say they just took all 3 of these, you know, I'm just grabbing them here. Like, now I'm in a situation where I'm probably going to end up, I know I'm going to end up with that particular spot, right? So I'm going to take one of the front end cars, and so I'm probably going to take, you know, maybe I'll just take this plus braking because it's got 3 empty spots on its tires. And so then I would end up with this as my middle spot. So I have a 70 mile an hour top speed. I have acceleration of 30. I have a braking of 40, which, you know, it's pretty cool, and a top speed of 50. And then after everybody's done, I would go ahead and I would take my blue car, my stick, if you will, and then the other car at the next highest speed goes there, the next highest speed there is there, and then the person that is 4th goes in that spot. So now you're ready to go ahead and race. So the very first turn, you have to go the speed limit that is situated that you're going. The very first turn is going to be the same. And so you're going to take this cube and you're going to put that on the 50 like so. And then you're going to go. You're going to go 5 spaces. You know, one space for every 10 miles an hour you're going. So you're just going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I'd be there. And so I'm just going to move these guys up. And I should mention that, like, you can't, you can change spots. You mean, as you can probably guess, you can go in and out, like, faster, you like, as far as the different locations, as far as, you're switching lanes or whatever, like, so diagonal movement is okay, you can turn, what have you. But, so then everybody's gone, right, and so now, let's just go ahead, and I, you know, I didn't, like, go through and figure out each of the speeds, just bear with me, I just want to show you how the mechanisms work, and how the turns work, or whatever. So, now the next turn starts, and now the players are going to say, okay, now you can accelerate, and so basically, everybody takes their cube and picks it up. They're going to think about, I can accelerate up to 30 miles an hour, but you'll notice I'm already going 50. And if I start hitting these 60 mile an hours over here on the outside track, and you'll notice that if you can move to the inside, they're going to be easier to go. I'm going to be saying, well, what? How fast do I want to go? If I can speed up another 30 miles an hour, but if I do that, I'm going to be at 80. And technically I can't even go 80 because my maximum speed is 70. So I can go up to 70. And I'd be able to go 7 spaces. Now, remember when I told you that these races go really quick? They go really quick. But you can make them longer if you want, or you can, say, go 2 laps or whatever you want to. Another thing that you can do to change up the game how you like. But so maybe I would just say, I'm just going to speed up to 60. Bam, like that. Okay, so now I've picked that I'm going to go 60, and the other players were going to pick as well. But now, depending upon if another player decided they're going to go faster, maybe this red car could go, you know, up to 90, they're going to go before me, and they're going to go first. And so, like, if that car, you know, like, was able to speed up to 90, let's just say 80, for example, and the red car went first, you know, it'd go 1, 2, 3, 4, and now they have the thing where they're probably going to move out if they're going 80, because they don't want to, you know, burn up a lot of rubber. So they could, you know, like, in this situation, I apologize, they go out here first, so they'd be 80. Now, here's the problem where they've just taken, they're going 20 miles an hour faster than that 60 mile an hour limit, right? So they're going to have to either use up 2 tire spots on their car, or they're going to have to use up a driver token that they have, or a tire spot, or 2 driver tokens. And so I forgot what we were here. We're right here, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's... You know, that'd be, let's just say he just went 70. So let's, because 80 would be stupid. He'd use up a lot of his driver tokens and his tire damage. But he's still going faster than us, so he would go 1, 2, 3, 4. Wait, ha, ah, can't. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, so probably not the best choice they ever made, but they'd be in first place, and they'd have to burn up either 2 spots on their tire, 3 spots on their tires, or any combination of tire spots or driver tokens that they want. And then when it came to our turn, since we were going 60, that kind of screws up our plans, right? Because we wanted to go 60 miles an hour where we know we'd be safe on these turns, but we can't now because we're going to get stuck butting up against the other car. And you have to go your full speed. You can't just say, oh, nope, I'm not going to go anymore. You are going to sometimes run into situations where you absolutely, positively have to stop, basically because there's 2 cars in front of you and you're not going to be able to go. But then if that happens, you're going to have to burn up driver tokens to be basically do an emergency brake. So because that player made that choice, what we could do is we could go, we're going 60, 1, 2, 3, and then we could go 4, and then this would cost us a tire or a driver token because of that spot, 4, 5, 6. And then we just take, maybe we're just going to take this token, and we're going to put it on there because we burned up some rubber like so. All right, so, and that's the way, and then the next turn, I'm not going to move the green and the yellow car right now, but the next turn, you're going to decide how fast you're going. You're going to do the same thing. And what happens is that you're going to be making dynamic changes to your speed depending upon what the other players are planning to do and what they're trying to do. Remember, these races are quick and they're fast and they're over with, and you are going to end up trying to just basically figure out what the other players are doing and trying to minimize the damage to your car, because there is one big thing, and I'm just going to kind of cheat here. I'm going to take these 2 cars out. I'm going to move them over here to show us that we're towards the end of the race, and we're here. So
you are in a situation where, like, you are racing neck and neck with another player, like so. And this is the finish line, this little line here. So it isn't so much who the first, because the idea is that every player is going, like, it's very possible. Like, sometimes you're going to have a player that just goes across it before anybody else. But a lot of times you're going to have situations where people are going to be crossing, and it's what really ends up mattering is who gets the furthest past the finish line, if more than one person passes the finish line on the exact same turn. But here's the problem with that. If you go too fast and you're unable to stop, if you're unable to either spend driver tokens or spend tire tokens, as if you get pushed into a turn, which you basically, I think in this game, you should always have a turn right after the end because it just makes it more exhilarating. If you're unable to spend the driver tokens or the tire tokens when you cross and you end up doing the turn and not being able to move, you spin out and your car explodes and there's a big giant fire and well, you make it out okay. You don't die or anything like that, but you don't qualify for winning the race. So in this situation, if like I was like, oh, I don't want to like lose this guy, so I'm gonna try to figure out I'm gonna go 80 or something along those lines, or I'm gonna try to go faster. Basically, you don't end up doing that because of the fact that you know you're going to lose. So you're trying to figure out, so like I'll go 70 and like I'll move out into the other path. But what if he went 80 and was like 1, 2, 3, 4, and then he had enough driver token here and another one there. And so he was basically taking up these spots, and like I was unable to slow down in time. And if I spun out, even though I was maybe going faster, and I'd end up like at a further rate that like the other person would, then unfortunately I'd lose because I'd spin out and my car would crash and I wouldn't qualify for the victory. When you get close to the finish line, what basically happens up is you're trying to, once again, figure out how fast the other people are going to go, figure out if they're going to try to block you, figure out if they're going to try to, force you to, you know, have to go into a turn that is going to be damaging to your car. And if they can do that, they can pull out a last second victory, and you have to try to avoid that as best as you possibly can. Vintage Racers is a very, very fast game. This is what I call like a lunchtime game for me. Back when I used to work at a big giant office building, this would be the type of game that I would play with my buddies while we were eating our sandwiches and talking about the day of work so far and maybe bemoaning the last meeting we were in. But this was a way just to kind of relax and enjoy each other's company and just have a quick game. But I also see this as the game that you play to start off a big game, night of gaming, or like to play at the end of a day of gaming. Or I see it as a fun little game that I can play with my kids because we all kind of grasp it really quickly and we have fun trying to figure out, you know, where to put our cars and where to move them and what have you. So let me talk about that and a whole lot more in my final thoughts. Oh, jeez. There you go. That is the Vintage Racers. Now, as I said, this is totally a game that I used to be able to, like, bring to my job when I used to work in a giant financial institution, i.e. bank. After I would, like, have, like, a long morning of work or whatever, I had a group of two or three other guys that played a lot of games with me, and we would, you know, try to have our lunches around the same time, and we'd go downstairs and meet in the, like, workroom, cafeteria, what have you, and we'd sit down and, like, play in. And I had a bag of games that I would bring with me to work, and they kind of just sat there. And this is totally a game that I'd have, and we just fish one out. Everybody knew the rules, set it up. You know, you got your sandwich in one hand, you got your thermos in the other, and you're just playing the game to have some fun, and just people are just able to chill and have a good time. This is totally a game where, I think it has the right combination of the two different aspects. As far as, like, the drafting of the car, which, you know, I mean, you have to kind of pick, you know, do I want to have, like, you know, that first, like, pole position part, you know, it's like, yeah, that's kind of nice, but is it in the long run going to be worth it to take that one without a lot of damage spaces on the car? What's the best combination of the three different parts that you can go with? Those sorts of things. And it is, but the nice thing about it is that if you feel like you just got, you know, like the bad car, if you will, and there's technically not really the bad car. I mean, like, I've had any type of car win these games. It has a lot to do with the positioning of the other players as they're moving and what have you. But if you end up with a bad car,
So what? The game is like, it's a quick, fast little game, and if you want to play again, then you move on and you set it up again, you set up a new track maybe, and then you shuffle up and put some different car parts out there for everybody, and then you draft the car again. You know, whoever finished last game gets to pick first this time, and they get to pick like the parts that they think are going to work best for them in that particular game. So it's one of those things where you can't really bemoan losing, and you can't really be, you know, too, well, I get super excited when I win, but any game, because I rarely, if ever, win. But it's one of those games where, like, you can just reset it and play it again. And as I said, it is totally a game that, like, is when you have, like, a super long game, you know, just, like, insert any, like, 3-hour, like, Forbidden Stars or Twilight Imperium type game or whatever, and you're kind of itching to still play something, or you don't want to call it a night yet, but, you know, you want something to cool yourself up. Or if, like, you're waiting for that fifth or sixth person for your big, giant, long game of war, I can't even think. The Game of Thrones, or something like that. You know, just like you're having a big long, and the one person just isn't there yet. Maybe they're picking up the pizza or whatever, and you want to play something once again that everybody knows how to play, and you can sit it down and you can play it. This is the type of game that fits the bill. Plus, it's a racing game, and if you like racing games, and I have a lot of friends out there that like racing games, and I do enjoy racing games just because it's immersive and it's fun and it's head to head stuff that I like. Then this is definitely a super cool, quick racing game that you can play. So, yeah, there you go. If you have any questions about Vintage Racers, by all means, ask away. I'll be happy to answer those as best as I can. As always, I really appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. It really means a lot to me. And as always, wherever you are, whatever you do, whatever you happen to be, try to be the best version of you that you possibly can be. As I've said, I guarantee you, the more that you smile and the more that you give love to the universe, the more the universe is going to give you back. And I know, man, I've had a really killer day today, and it tried its best to kind of beat me down. And I had to remind myself, hey, smile, be nice, you know, be positive, you know, try to be that person that people want to hang out with, try to be that person that people are going to want to, you know, have in their lives. And it's a thing where it's like, yeah, some days it's easy, some days it's hard, but the more you try it, the harder you work at it, the better off you're going to be, I guarantee it. So that's it for me. I'm the Undead Viking. You are you, and you are awesome. I will talk to you in the next video. You take it easy.